Very warm welcome to our biology class. Students, I am really happy to announce this. From today onwards, we are going to start to read the NCERT book, and even we are understanding what are all the points mentioned in the NCERT book perfectly. Because every year, the questions are coming from the NCERT book directly. If you observed in all the previous year NEET question papers and even all the state board question papers, all the questions are appearing from the NCERT book. So if we are very well with the NCERT, then 100% we are going to get even the good score in all our competitive exams. So today we are going to start with the human reproduction chapter from the second year. Okay, we will read the NCERT book properly and we will understand the things what they have mentioned in the NCERT book. In the introductory part of human reproduction, they are saying that, as you are aware, humans are sexually reproducing and viviparous. Students, you must remember that humans are the sexually reproducing organisms, because many more other animals are there. Those animals are reproducing by asexual mean, but the humans are the one who are producing sexually. Because in case of humans, even we used to find male and female, both of them are separate, means they are the dioecious. Sexes are separate here, and by the sexual reproduction they are going to give birth to the young one, that is known as an viviparous. There are the other animals are there, students. They are usually even lay the eggs also, but humans are the one who are giving birth to the young ones, viviparous animals we are. Then whatever the sexual reproduction is there, it is not going to occur in a one single step, students. It is going to occur with a many other events also, and all those events are discussed in this particular paragraph. So what are those events then? In a human reproduction, the whatever sexual events are there, the first event is gametogenesis. What does it mean by the gametogenesis, students? It is the process of formation of the haploid gametes. Whatever the process of haploid gamete formation is there in a male, it is known as spermatogenesis. In case of the female, it is known as an oogenesis. As a result of the spermatogenesis, in male, sperms are going to produce. And in case of the female, as a result of oogenesis, ovum is finally going to produce. Then, now you need to understand, sperms are formed and even the ovum is formed. But whatever this, both the gametes are there, whether is it necessary is there or not, both of them has to come closer with each other. Then and then only they are going to be get fertilized and leads into the formation of zygote. Hence what, there must be the necessary of sexual intercourses, and by the end of the sexual intercourses, second event is going to occur, that is known as insemination. Means by that time, sperms or the male gametes are going to be transported into the female reproductive tract. That is the end event you must have to understand and remember here. Now the sperms are deposited into the female reproductive tract, and in the female reproductive tract, by that time even the ovum is also going to released from the ovary, and it is going to receive in the fallopian tube, and both of the male gamete and female gamete, if they are simultaneously found in the fallopian tube, then they will lead into the third event of sexual reproduction. It is known as an fertilization. By that time, both these male and female gametes are going to fuse with each other. They leads into the formation of zygote. That will leads into the formation of zygote. And after, once the zygote is formed, have you remembered, students, where the zygote is got formed? Whether in a male body or female body? Yes, it is in the female body. And once in the female reproductive system, zygote is formed, that zygote started to divide mitotically, and that early mitotic divisions of the zygotes are known as in cleavages. And by every cleavage, blastomeres are going to be formed, and finally they leads into the formation of the structure like morula, and finally it will even going to convert as a blastocyst. And the blastocyst is the one which is going to be get implant in the uterus. It is the fourth event. What does it mean by the implantation? It is nothing but attachment of a blastocyst to the wall of uterus. And after once it is got attached properly, implanted properly, then the pregnancy is going to be begin. And whatever this entire period of pregnancy is there, it is considered as an gestation period. Students, you must have to remember during what stage it is going to be get implanted. And once the implantation occurs, that will lead into the pregnancy. And that pregnancy period is called as an gestation period. And in case of the human, gestation period is about 9 months. If you consider in the form of days, it is 258 days. The gestation period is going to vary from animals to animals, but in case of humans, it is 9 months. And during that entire 9 months, the fetus is started to grow in the womb of the mother. And finally, whenever it is fully going to develop, that will lead into the expulsion of that fully developed fetus. The process of delivery going to occur. And in biology, the process of delivery is called as an parturition. It is the sixth event. After the completion of the sixth event only, one of the child is going to be get born. We are giving birth to the young one. That process is called as an parturition. And as we are giving birth to the young one, hence we are considered even as a viviparous. And remember, students, whatever these all the events we have discussed here, gametogenesis, insemination, and fertilization, implantation, gestation, parturition, whatever these all the six events we have understood here, all these events are going to occur after puberty only. Means during the childhood, these events are not going to take place. But whatever earlier events are there, students, like spermatogenesis and oogenesis, if you compare, it is significantly differs from the male and female. Both of them are leads into the formation of the gametes only, but they are significantly differs, because in case of the male, spermatogenesis is going to begins whenever they reach to the age of maturity. But in case of the female, it is not like that. The oogenesis process is going to be begin whenever the ovary is going to be formed in the female fetus, whenever that fetus is still in the womb of the mother. Then it will keep on dividing and enters into the certain stage of the meiosis one. Further, it is going to be continued once the FSH started to secrete from the anterior pituitary gland. Hence, it is written here, both whatever that events are there, that events are significantly differs between. And there is a remarkable difference between the reproductive events in male and female. You are going to understand this, whatever remarkable difference is there, in a very well manner in the next classes. Here even the example is given. For example, sperm formation continues in the old age man, and but whatever oogenesis is there, the formation of ovum is going to be ceased in woman around the age of 50 years. So that is what the remarkable difference is given. Many other remarkable differences are there, students. We are going to understand all those remarkable differences in the next classes. I hope this class has become very useful for you all. And from the tomorrow onwards, you are going to get almost every day NCERT reading videos. Please observe each and every videos and understand what is exactly mentioned in the NCERT book. What you need to be remember from this paragraph, students, you have to remember that humans are sexually reproducing and they are viviparous. And then you need to be remember all these events in a proper sequence: gametogenesis, insemination, fertilization, implantation, gestation, and parturition. I just request you to remember at least the initial GI, FI, GP. In that way you can properly remember. Otherwise you can make the sentence out of that all the initial words. So you remember that sentence. that will help you to remember all these events in a proper sequence, because most of the time they will ask you the question, find the correct sequence of sexual reproductive events. And one more question that may ask from this particular paragraph is, during what stage the implantation occurs? It is during the blastocyst stage. And one more question they may ask you, students, during what age ceasing of formation of ovum is going to occur in female? It is around 50 years. And in the next classes, we are going to understand regarding the male and proper anatomy of it, physiology of it, everything we are going to understand in detail from the NCERT book properly. And even other animated videos are also I am uploading, students. I already given the some videos link in the description box. You can observe all those videos also. 100% you are going to understand the subject in a very proper manner. I hope this type of the reading of NCERT book has helped you a lot. Please write your comments and even write your requirements also. Like this video, share with your friends, and even if you not yet subscribed, please do subscribe also. Thank you once again, students.